TCS is the short name of the inorganic compound trichlorosilane. Purified TCS is the principal precursor to ultra-pure silicon in the semiconductor industry. TCS is colorless, volatile liquid. In water, it rapidly decomposes to produce a silicon polymer while giving off hydrogen chloride fumes. It is extremely flammable in air or in contact with oxidants while giving off silicon dioxide and hydrogen chloride fumes. Thus, TCS is toxic, corrosive, and flammable. In this video, we will demonstrate how to handle a leaking TCS package and the correct containment process. Here are the containment tools that are going to be used. They are plastic bag, PTFE sheet, PVC tape, silicon caulking, and a titan belt, and a nitrogen source cylinder will also be used when required. Before conducting TCS containment, proper PPE should be worn depending on leak level. For gas leakage, personnel should wear level B suit, including safety boots, chemical resistance gloves, coverall, and four-phase respirator. For liquid leakage, level A suit is required, including safety boots, chemical resistance gloves, coverall, and self-containment breathing apparatus inside the coverall. In case that valve leaks, personnel wearing level B suit should cover the head of the drum with a proper-sized plastic bag, then tightly sealed by PVC tape. Care must be taken to the area where UN plate attaches on. Seals at four sides of the plate should be done to prevent gas leaking from the gap between the plate and the drum shoulder. If the available plastic bags at site are not large enough, then consider alternative position for sealing, such as around the flange or around the drum neck. After that, connect a nitrogen source to one side of the plastic bag with seal by PVC tape, and at the other side to a bucket of caustic chemical solution, which will neutralize TCS carried out with nitrogen purge. The final condition of valve leakage containment is such that the valve should be covered and sealed by a plastic bag, and with nitrogen purge, the leaked TCS should be reacted out in the bucket. In case that TCS drum body leaks and liquid comes out, personnel wearing level A suit should firstly enclose the drum with spill control material to control the liquid from flowing to elsewhere. After that, adob some silicon sealant onto the PTFE sheet and then attach it onto the leak point. Then use ratchet belt to tighten the PTFE sheet. To prevent the buckle from damaging the drum body, pieces of PTFE sheet should be used as cushion between buckle and the drum body. And to summarize, in this video, we have learned that TCS is toxic, corrosive, and flammable. Thus, in case gas phase leaks, personnel should wear level B suit, while liquid phase leaks, level A suit is recommended. If valve leaks and gas phase comes out, the top of the drum should be covered by a plastic bag with PVC tape sealing. After that, nitrogen purge and the connection to a bucket of water with caustic chemical is also recommended. If drum body leaks and liquid phase comes out, a PTFE sheet with silicon sealant should be attached onto the body and tightened by ratchet belt.